This is the little digital helicopter game that I've made. You fly this little helicopter through a series of caves by either pressing a button to make it raise or letting it go so that it'll lower. In the upper left, you see a hexadecimal number that shows you how far you've gotten. And if you crash into anything, then it will show you how far you got and what the high score is in hexadecimal. If your score is higher than the high score, then it'll save it to memory for later, so that it'll be there when you play again. Every time the helicopter moves, a lot of stuff happens. The entire terrain gets drawn, the helicopter gets drawn, the little tiny indicator thing in the upper left that shows you how far you've gotten is updated, and the difficulty is increased based on how far you've gotten, so it speeds up as you get farther down the level. And also, the button is checked to see whether it's pressed or not, so that the microcontroller knows whether to raise or lower the helicopter. That all seems pretty simple, but doing it on this little tiny microcontroller is actually a pretty difficult task. The helicopter game looks pretty simple, but it's a lot more complicated than it looks. If you flip it over, you see this big mess of wires, the batteries, and the button that you use to play it. Under this big mess of wires is a little tiny chip that looks like this. And this little chip is called the ATiny13. It's a microcontroller from Atmel. Inside this chip is 1 kilobyte of programmable flash memory and 64 bytes of RAM. And if that doesn't mean a lot to you, then just think of it as 1,024 numbers that you have to define whatever you want to run on the chip, which in this case is my game. And the 64 bytes are like 64 numbers that you have to remember everything that goes on in your game, which in this case is really just the height of the helicopter for me because of some tricks that I use. If you want to know more about the specifics of this project, or see any of the other ones that I have made, then head over to my website at hackniac.com/blog.